we tampered with the stability of space-time.
The multiverse is a concept about which we know frighteningly little.
Some scientists are now suggesting that the Big Bang is just one moment in an eternal cycle of cosmic creation and dissolution. Scientists are working on different theories to try and explain how the universe could have come into existence. One of these theories is that our universe is in fact one of many universes, or multiverses. According to Brian Cox, there was a time before the Big Bang in which the universe did exist.
It's interesting, this idea of the Big Bang created the universe. That's what Einstein's theory says. That's textbook cosmology, if you like. But the current textbook picture is there was a phase in the universe's life before the Big Bang, if you define the Big Bang as the hot, dense phase from which the universe appeared to sort of burst forth 13.8 billion years ago. And that phase is called inflation. So that sounds fanciful, but that's standard cosmology at the moment. The big question then is, well, what started the inflation? What stopped the inflation? How long did the inflation go on for? And so some of these theories, they're called eternal inflation theories, suggest that there might not be just our universe, the bit that we can see, but there might be many universes, perhaps an infinite number of them, and they may be being produced all the time.
The multiverse idea has arisen in many versions, primarily in cosmology, quantum mechanics, and philosophy, and often asserts the actual physical existence of different potential configurations or histories of the known observable universe. According to this theory, we exist in what could be considered just one bubble within a sea of many universes, whose properties differ from patch to patch, spanning all physical possibilities. Brian Cox supports the idea that many universes can exist at the same time. He explains the theory of eternal inflation and how these so-called bubble universes could be formed.
So what we think happened is that the universe was accelerating exponentially fast. It means it was doubling and doubling and doubling in size. And the numbers are ridiculous. We think that if you started with a universe that was smaller than a single atom, then it would be bigger by a long way than the whole observable universe with 350 billion galaxies in it in less than a million, 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 millionths of a second. So a very rapid, exponentially fast expansion. And when that stopped, all the energy that was driving that expansion got dumped into space. It heated it up. It produced the particles of matter out of which we're made and all the things that we see out there in the sky. And that's what we see as the Big Bang. This idea that that may lead to multiple universes, it's still scientifically valid, and there are people who do research into that, try and find out if there really are an infinite number of universes. This is no longer just speculative. There's actually science you can do.
Many modern physicists think about a multiverse in the context of the many worlds theory of quantum mechanics. According to this theory, when a particle is measured, it can result in either just one outcome or multiple outcomes. The universe splits into different universes in one of the outcomes, each being a separate reality. According to Cox, the theory could also answer the question as to why our universe seems to be fine-tuned for life.
Why is our universe so perfect for life? Why do stars make carbon and oxygen, the elements that you need for life? Why is everything so beautifully balanced so that living things can exist? The answer in these cases is because, well, every universe exists. Every possible combination of the laws of nature exists in different universes. So the reason we have to see a universe that allows us to exist, obviously. We could ask the question, well, how likely is that? Well, the answer, if there are an infinite number of them, is it's inevitable, because there's every possible kind of universe.
The multiverse consists of many universes that could be scattered throughout the vast emptiness of space. Together, these universes comprise everything that exists: the entirety of space, time, matter, energy, information, and the physical laws that describe them. The multiverse hypothesis isn't accepted universally by physicists. One of the reasons for this is that there is no direct evidence to back up the idea of a multiverse. Nevertheless, proponents of the multiverse idea are trying to develop new ways to infer exactly how the multiverse bubble up, and what happens when those bubble universes bump into each other.
there may be extra dimensions in the universe. Forget, you can't picture four or five or six dimensions. So imagine that we're just living on a sheet of paper, let's say. Then there are theories where here's our universe floating around, and there can be another universe floating around in a big room like this. So there are more spatial dimensions, and we're just on a sheet floating around in this bigger multiverse. And one of the theories about what caused the Big Bang is that actually what it was two of these sheets, the membranes, as they're called. So they collide together and separate. And when they collide together, they heat themselves up, and you get something that looks like a Big Bang on that sheet of space and time, if you like. So that's another different theory for what happened before the Big Bang.
Another possibility for a multiverse is that of the baby universe, in which a quantum gravitational process would create a new region of space-time that would bud off and potentially disconnect from its parent universe. This would lead to a tree of universes unlikely to interact after their formation. The process has been speculated to occur in the interiors of black holes. Our universe may be nested inside a black hole that is itself part of a larger universe. All the black holes that astronomers have seen, each is more massive than our Sun and formed at least hundreds of thousands of years after the Big Bang, as our universe grew and evolved. But there is another type of black hole astronomers haven't yet seen, but think could exist. These are primordial black holes. As their name suggests, primordial black holes were born very early in the life of the universe, a mere fraction of a second after the Big Bang. A new study suggests that primordial black holes, which formed in the early universe, could be hidden baby universes, since no light can escape from a black hole. Everything that existed inside a baby universe would never know that our universe exists.
Well, we know what happens when something falls across the so-called event horizon. So that's the region of space. If you cross that region of space, then nothing can get out. You'd have to travel faster than light to get out. But we don't know what happens when something goes to the center of a black hole. It's called a singularity. And the reason we don't know is because our current laws of physics break down in those very extreme conditions. And we need a new theory. And the theory is often called a quantum theory of gravity. It's some kind of unification between our theory of everything else, which are called quantum theories, and our theory of gravity, which is Einstein's theory. It's the best theory we have. So we need a better theory. Somebody has to come up with a better theory, and no one's been clever enough to do so far.
Einstein's theory of gravity allows these baby universes to exist in a state that appears different to an observer on the inside and the outside. An internal observer sees it as an expanding universe, while an outside observer, such as us, sees it as a black hole. It's possible that these black holes comprise a significant fraction of the dark matter that conceal the underlying structure of multiple universes. The matter we know and that makes up all stars and galaxies only accounts for 5% of the content of our universe. The rest of the universe is much more mysterious and unknown. However, it isn't completely empty. It turns out that roughly 68% of the universe is dark energy. Dark matter makes up about 27%. For years, scientists have been trying to solve the mystery of dark matter. They have been able to infer the existence of dark matter only from the gravitational effect it seems to have on visible matter.
We're absolutely sure now it's there from many different measurements, from the way that galaxies rotate, the way that galaxies interact with each other, and the whole evolution of the universe actually requires there to be dark matter, about five times as much dark matter as there is matter. So it completely outweighs the stuff out of which we are made, and all the stars we can see in the sky are made. So it doesn't glow, it's not stars, which is why it's called dark matter. There are theories, many theories in particle physics, that suggest that there are other particles out there that are waiting to be discovered at places like the Large Hadron Collider. And so I think the evidence tends to suggest there should be some new kind of particle. And we may discover it. We have experiments in underground laboratories that are literally looking for the dark matter that we fly through as the Earth orbits around the Sun and the solar system goes around the galaxy and the galaxy passes through the universe. We're flying through this dark matter, but it interacts very weakly with normal matter.
Multiverse theories have been widely criticized as speculation or philosophy rather than science, which is indeed a legitimate concern. Multiverse defenders, however, contend that a description of the observable universe as one part of a multiverse can be much simpler than a description of the observable universe as the only universe at all. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.